Hi everyone, today we're going to learn how to implement the last type of gRPC, that is bidirectional streaming or bidi-streaming. This streaming allows client and server to send multiple requests and multiple responses to each other in parallel. We will write an API for client to rate a stream of laptops with score from 1 to 10, and the server will respond with a stream of average scores for each of the laptops. Alright, let's start. The first thing we need to do is to define a new bidi-streaming RPC in the laptopservice.proto file. We define the rate laptop request with two fields, the laptop ID and the score. Then the rate laptop response with three fields, the laptop ID, the number of times this laptop was rated, and the average rated score. Now we define the rate laptop RPC, with input is a stream of rate laptop request, and output is a stream of rate laptop response. Alright, now let's run makegen to generate the codes. After the codes are generated, we can see an error inside the server main.go file. This is because the laptop service server interface now requires one more method, rateLaptop. We can find the signature of this method inside the laptopservice.pb.go file. So let's copy it and paste in the laptopserver.go file. Just return nil for now and update this input parameter. Okay, the error is gone. We will come back to implement this method later. Now we need to create a new rating store to save the laptop ratings. I will define a rating store interface. It has one function, add, that takes a laptop ID and a score as input, and returns the updated laptop rating or an error. The rating will consist of two fields. One is count, which is the number of times the laptop is rated, and the other is the sum of all rated scores. Then we will write an in-memory rating store that implements the interface. Similar to the in-memory laptop store, here we will need a mutex to handle concurrent access. And we have a rating map with key is a laptop ID and value is a rating object. Then we define a function to create a new in-memory rating store. In this function, we just need to initialize a rating map. Okay, now let's implement the add function. As we're going to change the internal data of the store, we have to acquire a lock here. Then we get the rating of the laptop ID from the map. If the rating is not found, then we just create a new object with count is 1. And sum in the input score. Else, we increase the rating count by 1 and add the score to the sum. Finally, we put the updated rating back to the map and return it to the caller. Then we are done with the store. Now, let's go back to implement the server. We add a new rating store to the laptop server struct and also add it to this new laptop server function. Because of this change, some errors will show up, so let's fix them. In the laptop client test.go file, we add a new rating store parameter to the start test laptop server function and send it in the code to create a new laptop server. Because this rating store is not needed in all current unit tests, we can simply set it to nil here. Here and here. in the laptop server test.go file, we can also pass nil to this function. And all errors in the test files are gone. Now there's only one error left in the server main.go file. Here we have to create a new in-memory rating store and pass it into the create new laptop server function. Then we are done. Now let's come back to implement the rate laptop function. Since we will receive multiple requests from the stream, we must use a for loop here, similar to what we did on the client streaming RPC. Before doing anything, let's check the context error to see if it's already cancelled or deadline exceeded or not. Then we call stream.receive to get a request from the stream. If error is end of file, then there's no more data. We simply break the loop. Else, if error is not nil, we log it and return the error with status code unknown to the client. Otherwise, we can get the laptop ID and the score from the request. Let's write a log here saying that we have received a request with this laptop ID and score. Now we should check if this laptop ID really exists or not by using the laptopstore.find function. If an error occurs, we return it with a status code internal. If the laptop is not found, we return the status code not found to the client. If everything goes well, we call ratingstore.add to add the new laptop score to the store and get back the updated rating object. If there's an error, we return internal status code. Else, we create a rate laptop response with laptop ID in the input laptop ID, rated count taken from the rating object, and every score is computed using the sum and count of the rating. We call stream.send to send the response to the client. If error is not nil, we log it and return status code unknown. And that's it, we're done with the server. Now before moving to the client, I will add a new function to generate a random laptop score in the sample package. To be simple, let's say it's going to be a random integer between 1 and 10. Alright, now let's implement the client. First we define a rate laptop function with 3 input parameters. A laptop client, a list of laptop IDs, and their corresponding scores. In this function, we create a new context with timeout after 5 seconds. Then we call laptopClient.rateLaptop with the created context. The output is a stream or an error. If error is not nil, we just return it. Else, we have to make a channel to wait for the responses from the server. Note that the request and responses are sent concurrently. So here we have to start a new Go routine to receive the responses. And the wait response channel will receive an error when it occurs, or a nil if all responses are received successfully. In the Go routine, we use a for loop and call stream.receive to get a response from the server. If error is EOF, it means there's no more responses. So we send nil to the wait response channel and return. Else, if error is not nil, we send the error to the wait response channel and return as well. If no errors occur, we just write a simple log. Okay, now after this go routine, we can start sending requests to the server. Let's iterate through the list of the laptops and create a new request for each of them with the input laptop ID and the corresponding input scores. Then call stream.send to send the request to the server. If we get an error, just return it. Note that here we call stream.receiveMessage to get the real error, just like what we did in the previous lecture with client streaming RPC. If no error occurs, we write a log saying the request is sent. Now, one important thing that we must do after sending all requests is to call stream.closeSend to tell the server that we won't send in more data. And finally, read from the wait response channel and return the received error. The wait laptop function is completed. Now we will write a test wait laptop function to call it. Let's say we want to wait 3 laptops, so we declare a slice to keep the laptop IDs and use a for loop to generate a random laptop. Save its ID to the slice and call createLaptop function to create it on the server. Then we also make a slice to keep the scores. Now I want to rate these 3 laptops in multiple routes. So I will use a for loop here and ask if we want to do another route of rating or not. If the answer is no, we break the loop. Else, we generate a new set of scores for the laptops. And call rateLaptop function to rate them with the generated scores. If an error occurs, we write a fatal log. And that's all. Now in the main function, just call testRateLaptop. And we are all set. Let's run the server. Then run the client. 3 laptops are created. Red laptop? Yes. As you can see, we sent 3 requests with scores of 10, 8, and 4, and received 3 responses with rated count of 1 and average scores of 10, 8, and 4. Good. Now let's do another rating route. This time the scores we sent are 6, 1, and 5, and the responses has rated counts of 2, and the average scores have been updated to 8, 4.5, and 4.5, which are all correct. You can do the math. We can try another route, and it's working as expected. Awesome. Now I'm going to show you how to test this bidirectional streaming RPC. Let's go to laptop-client-test.go file. The test setup will be very similar to that of the upload image. So I just copy and paste it here. Change the test name to test client rate laptop. Remove this image folder. Change this image store to rating store. And pass it into the start test laptop server function instead of the image store. Alright, now we call laptop client.rateLaptop with a background context to get the stream. Require no error. For simplicity, we just rate 1 SQL laptop, but we will rate it 3 times with a score of 8, 7.5, and 10 respectively. So the expected average score after each time will be 8, 7.75, and 8.5. We define n as the number of rated times. And use a for loop to send multiple requests. Each time we will create a new request with the same laptop ID and a new score. we call stream.send to send the request to the server and require no errors to be returned. To be simple, I will not create a separate Go routine to receive the responses. Here, I will use a for loop to receive them and use an index variable to count how many responses we have received. Inside the loop, we call stream.receive to receive a new response. If error is EOF, then it's the end of the stream. We just require that the number of responses we received must be equal to n, which is the number of requests we sent, and we return immediately. Else, there should be no error. The response laptop ID should be equal to the input laptop ID. The rated count should be equal to index plus 1. And the average score should be equal to the expected value. Now let's run the test. It's timeout after 30 seconds. That's because I forget to close end the stream. So let's call it here. Require no error. And rerun the test. Now it passed. Let's run the whole package test. All passed. Excellent. And that wraps up today's lecture about implementing bidirectional streaming RPC in Go. In the next video, we will learn how to do that in Java. Thank you for watching, happy coding, and I will see you in the next lecture.